Monitor, 5106 South Whispering Sands Drive, Casa Grande, 5193. Mr. Mayor, council members, this is the first time for me too, and it's a lot easier on Sunday morning when I get up and share some testimony with all the people that I know in my church, so it's a lot easier. You know, I'm learning a lot about life, about taxes, about God, and I appreciate the fact that you guys opened up the word of prayer and you still say pledge allegiance and you include the phrase under God in there. That means a lot to me. I've been a Casa Grande resident for almost 2 years now. We lived in Tempe for a while and we finally were able to move out to the country. And I want to be involved, and I want to do it not based on my opinion, but what my faith dictates. Because my faith has to dictate what goes on in my life, not my opinion, because there's 7 billion people on the planet, so we could have 7 billion opinions about taxes. My God says in Exodus 20, verse 15, thou shalt not steal. And in my opinion and my interpretation of God's word, it's stealing to tax. I can never own my property outright because of property tax. Once the mortgage is paid for, what do I got? I've got rent to the government for the rest of my life. And if I can't work anymore, I'm retired, I'm whatever, I still have a payment. Now, I got services I have to pay for, but I get something for that. I pay my electric bill, I pay my water bill. But if I can't pay those, then fine, I don't get those services. But if I can't pay my taxes, the government comes in and takes my property. That's anti-biblical. And that's what God's word tells me. And nobody else is going to come to the city gates and I have to do it and say, this is what God's word says. And I either believe it or I don't. I can justify it in a lot of different ways, and I appreciate the comments of the gentleman before me and the examples that he gave. And as I sat here tonight, I listened to some of the proposals that came by. I don't claim to know it all or understand all of the intricacies of it. I do understand the police vehicles wear out faster than a personal vehicle does because they drive them more. I understand that. But I also have to weigh in some intelligent questions that, you know, well, what about the 2011 trucks that didn't sell? They could have been probably bought at a much lower price than a 2012 vehicle with no mileage on it. You know, and just like the gentleman before me stated, you know, I have so much money to work with, and when that money runs out, then I don't get to go borrow from anybody or lay that burden on anybody else. I don't have cable TV. I don't have all the luxuries that some people consider necessities nowadays. I don't have that stuff. I live within my means. I live a very simple life, and I see what's going on in the country. It's not just in the city of Casa Grande, you know, trying to ask for more taxes on my property. It's nationwide, and that's kind of why we're American in the first place, because we're taxed to death, and we are taxed to death. And I understand some services need to be provided, but you know, there's a plan in God's word that lays it out where the government isn't responsible for being big brother or taking care of all these different needs. It's not their responsibility. They're there for a certain purpose, and it's spelled out in there. I'm not going to give you a sermon. But I feel that it's not the city, the state, the county, or the federal government's right to tax property like this and never leave a way out for somebody. When you have an 80-year-old woman who doesn't have any children or doesn't have anybody to take care of her, what is she supposed to do when the property tax exceeds the fixed income that she's on? There's nothing that she can do except for move out or wait until somebody evicts her because the taxes are behind and they come and take the property. So it's not easy coming because it seems to me, even though I don't watch TV, I see what's going on in the world, and it seems as though God's plans are more and more unpopular in today's world. And if we're going to succeed, we need to go back to Him, not further away from Him. And not my opinion. It's what God said, and His plan works. And it's a history book full of His plan working. And when people go away